People call synapse and kernel viruses all day. You might know what's wrong with that. And if you don't, that's understandable. You might be new to exploiting. And I'm going to be telling you 5 reasons why people say certain exploits are viruses and then go crazy saying they're Bitcoin miners, saying they give you rats, and a lot more stuff that is just not true. So first off, the first problem that a lot of people have, and this is a complete mistake on their part, is downloading phishing and scam videos. Now you might be saying,
are your videos phishing and scam videos?
Well, no, okay. To that I'd say the most people that you know in this community, so people like OneFO, Sir Meme, Furky, Nuke vs. City, and anybody else, I'm sorry, I can't think of everybody off the top of my head. But people like that are obviously not scamming. But what I'm referring to is videos that get spam posted by robots, not even people, that are just literally viruses. In the description, what you'll see in all these videos is something along the lines of get the script here, get the script right there, and then it'll give you a password to the download, which will be something along the lines of 123 ABCD ABC 123, something just like that. And you might have seen these videos. I see them all the time when I'm searching for a certain script. I want to play a certain game with a certain script. I'm searching for it. And those videos get posted like so often. So if you guys actually just search up a game. So as you can see, I'm searching up Arsenal Roblox script. And I search by the most recent. What are those? Those are obviously the exact same scam videos I'm talking about. So those are things you 100% want to avoid. I've actually downloaded one of those before. And this is kind of embarrassing, but you know, it is what it is. It was actually a Fortnite cheat. This is like years ago. Okay, don't judge me. But I did download one of these videos. I wasn't that dumb, so looked through a lot of these videos, but I was getting really desperate. And I was just like, okay,
I'll open it. What's the worst that can happen?
And once I opened it, it opened a command prompt for like 5 seconds, and then it closed it. And then every time I typed a letter on my keyboard, it would open a command prompt and then type the letter that I typed on the command prompt and then close itself. And then I also started to get pop-up ads on my home screen. It was not good. So hopefully you learned from my mistake. And that about wraps up the first point, which is those 123 fake script videos. Let's move on to the second point, which will be VirusTotal being the judge of what is a virus and what is not. Look, there are a lot of good tools that can help you gauge whether an exploit is actually a virus or not. For example, the NSpy, that can help a lot of people, but VirusTotal is certainly not one of them. Maybe in other things, but exploiting, it is not. It is not it. It is not. Because VirusTotal works just like any other antivirus and literally functions as the other antiviruses, and it'll give you the same exact false positives. And you're like,
what's a false positive?
You're dumb. I'm just kidding. You're not that dumb. I will be telling you what a false positive is in the last step. So if you want to, go ahead and skip to that. It's right there. You know, it just scroll across the bar and you'll be able to see where that is. But as I was saying, getting thousands of like marks from VirusTotal telling you something is a virus is not very good. And it's not going to give you a real answer because it's going to say it's a virus no matter what. Literally, the Evon developer made a software which was just, it had one line of code that just said hello world, and then he made it into an exe, put it into VirusTotal, and it gave like 10 virus flags. Like, it's not a virus. That literally is not a virus in any way. So if anything, that should tell you that, you know, it's not very accurate. So that's basically the second reason, and this is something that a lot of people do, is judge off of the VirusTotal. That is not the way to go, and that is the least effective way to determine if something is a virus, but probably the easiest, so that's why people choose it. Come on guys, do better. But that's just about the second reason, so let's move on to the third reason, which is gonna be seeing FPS drops and then calling an executor a virus. Now, we've all been there, and I've actually also been there. I did this JGSploit review Roblox exploiting experience, okay? Oh, bam, headshot, there you go. That's what happens in your exploit. Oh, monkey in the middle guy's dead. What is going on? My mouse is like jittering. Is it a virus video? And I got like one frame after I executed a script with change exploit. And look, it is what it is. And I didn't call it a virus at the end. I don't think a lot of people stuck until the end of the video, but if you did, then you would have heard that. But if you didn't, then you would have been left with the wrong impression. So what happens once you inject an executor into Roblox is it actually physically injects the DLL of the exploit into the Roblox process. And now, instead of it just being Roblox, it's also the DLL on top of that. So, as you can probably imagine, that puts more strain on your computer and resulting in less frames. And that's just with your executor injected. Now, if you execute a script, that's even more. So at the end of the day, you're gonna have a lot of more strain on your computer, which will result in your frames being way lower than they originally were. So that's something people get confused with very often. They're like,
oh my gosh, why is this happening? You know, virus.
It is not a virus. It is literally just how executors work. And this is something I really need to hit home because a lot of people don't understand this. And if they see that the Roblox is getting less frames than usual, then they just blame the executor, which it actually is kind of the executor. It just depends how well optimized the DLL and the script is. But you know, it's because you injected and you executed a script. Come on. But that is the third reason. So let's move on to the fourth one. The fourth reason is going to be installing pop-ups or ads. We've all been there. We go to get a script. We get a pop-up. Understandable, okay? Or we go to get a script from Linkvertise installer, okay? Now where you guys mess up is you actually install the pop-ups or you install the ads from the Linkvertise or FileDM installer. Obviously, they're ads, so they want you to install them, but you're not actually supposed to install them. I don't know what to tell you, but you guys have to be careful when getting scripts. This is the only way to prevent this, and I mention it in every single one of my videos. I try to convince you guys to not download the ad, and I tell you exactly how to do it. But if you don't watch the video, then that doesn't really help you. So as long as you watch the showcase video and follow my instructions, you can get through that completely safely. But if you don't, that's where you start to get into a little bit of trouble if you don't know what you're doing. Or if you're just not careful, literally, because if you just spam next on the like installer for Evon or the Linkvertise installer for certain scripts that other YouTubers use, then you're going to install like four different ads, which you probably don't want. But if you watch my video through and through, and you actually watch the tutorial, I show you what to do, how to decline the ads, and all that stuff, which is what I want you guys. I don't want you guys to install the ads if you don't want them, but if you don't watch it, I can't help you. So that is a really big reason a lot of people get confused, and they might even download a pop-up, and then they're like, oh yeah, this is the script, and then they open it, and it is definitely not the script. And that's exactly the reason I mention it in every single video, because I gotta hit it home. But that's actually the fourth reason, and let's move on to the fifth one, and the last one, which is the false positives. And if you don't know what that is, you're about to know. So basically, a false positive is your antivirus believing a certain program or file is dangerous or malicious. And that happens very often, especially when you're exploiting. So a very good example is Evon. A lot of people get confused, which it makes sense if you don't know much about exploiting, you don't know much about antiviruses and how false positive works, you can get probably confused. But here's the thing, they're not actually viruses. SynapseX will give you false positives, Kernel will give you false positives, Evon will give you false positives, JJSplay will give you... Okay, that's not a good example, is it? Point being, all executors will give you a false positive no matter how well reputable or how safe they actually are in reality. You'll still get a false positive. And the reason that happens is because all executors use a certain file, which is like a DLL, and those DLLs can be used for more malicious purposes. But in our case, it's used to actually hack Roblox. I guess, is that malicious? But anyways, we use those DLLs to inject into the Roblox process and then inject our code, which is the scripts that you guys use. So in return, Windows is like, huh, this doesn't look right. What is this guy doing with this program? It's probably a virus. And then it tells you, this program is a virus. Delete it right now. Virus, delete it. And some of you guys believe it. And like, oh my gosh, it's a virus. And then you freak out. But I'm here to tell you, do not worry about that because it is not actually a virus. Another more specific case of that is like Evon. Evon uses a very specific monocode for its WebView typing area where it automatically pre-writes the code that you're trying to type, which is very useful if you guys are trying to write scripts in Evon, which I definitely recommend. It's a great executor. You guys can get it in the last link in the description. But yeah, it's an executor that has that function. Not a lot of other exploits have it. I think some of the only other exploits that have that feature is like Scriptware. I can't think of anything else off the top of my head, but there is probably one or two more. But yeah, it uses that specific function, which uses Microsoft's WebView, which uses a more programs in the back end. And one of those programs gets often flagged as like a crypto thing. I don't know why, but it does. And a lot of people think Yvonne is a miner because they give that false positive and they're like, oh my gosh, what is going on? But in reality, it's completely safe. And I want you guys to think about it logically. Would I really do? Why would I do that? You know, it's hard to be reasonable if you're like panicking, thinking you got some dangerous stuff on your computer, because your computer is very important to all of us. We don't go outside. That's basically all. So hopefully you did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure to leave a like. Watch this video right there. It's the previous video that I did on this. It's a little outdated, but there are some extra points that you might want to hear about. But I appreciate you for sticking along till the end of the video. Really appreciate your support, and hopefully I'll catch you all in the next one. Let me know how this new setup is. Is it good? Is it bad? I'm still tweaking it. All right, bye.